What is up, all my dorks, nerds, geeks, and gamers? It's your host, Ghost, here, and today we're going to be talking about Spider-Man Spider-Shadow 4. If you guys don't know already, this series has been freaking amazing. Issues 1 through 3 have been really good. They've been taking a lot of Spider-Man characters in new directions, including J. Jonah Jameson, including Peter Parker, including Eddie Brock, including a lot of the Sinister Six villains, MJ. A lot of characters have went in totally different directions than what they originally traditionally do in an Amazing Spider-Man storyline, and I'm really loving the ultra-violence and the more mature tones that they're going for in this storyline. So let's hop right in and see what this issue has for us, and let's talk about it. So, we start off with J. Jonah Jameson taking Peter Parker back to the apartment to talk to MJ and to make sure she's safe and all that stuff. Because we know the symbiote is still out there, and we know that it did affect the Fantastic Four at the very end of that issue. So Peter Parker basically goes there, he picks up MJ, and he tells J. Jonah Jameson, you need to go home, you need to let this cool off and get over this and let it pass over. And as he's taking MJ home, he notices the Baxter Building is covered in symbiote, like completely covered from head to toe to symbiote. He's basically like, this is my fault. I knew what I was doing, but I wanted to do it. The suit didn't make me do this, and MJ argues the other way, that it was the suit's fault, the suit was affecting his mind. And so they have this nice little sweet MJ-Peter Parker moment between each other. We then cut to the Avengers, who are outside of the Fantastic Four Tower with a bunch of the other Avengers and the Fantastic Four who aren't infected, including Sue Storm and their son, and Johnny Storm, who Johnny Storm goes off on Peter Parker as soon as he sees him. Just for causing all this, for bringing the symbiote into the building in the first place. You get a nice shot of Peter standing outside the building, debating on if he should go in or not, because he doesn't know if he'll be controlled or not. And Captain America kind of has the same conversation with him, and he says, you know what, I need to do this, I'm going to do this. So he ends up heading in, MJ follows right behind him, she says, you're not going to do this alone, and she follows in with him. So does Johnny Storm. So Johnny Storm, Peter, and MJ are in this Venom-infected tower. There's these two security guards, which are like brainwashed by the symbiote. And MJ ends up picking up the gun off the desk because she's like, hey, you're Spider-Man, you're Johnny Storm, I need a gun, okay? I don't have any self-defense. So they head up the tower to find Mr. Fantastic and to see if he's okay and to see what's going on with him. Johnny Storm gets attacked by Ben Grimm, who is a symbiote version of Ben Grimm. I love the design. They have a nice battle between Johnny Storm and Ben Grimm real quick, and then Peter Parker comes in to fight, and he gets whooped bad until he decides to use his anger, and he unleashes his full rage on Ben Grimm and takes him down. Well, he doesn't take him down. He pushes him through the tower walls in front of the Avengers, and the Avengers are ready to take him down for Spider-Man. Just then we get to Johnny Storm confronting Mr. Fantastic, who looks terrifying, by the way, almost like a Slender Man with a Venom version face and looking face and stuff like that. So terrifying enemy. He's talking to Johnny Storm. Johnny Storm goes to attack him, and he says, you can't hurt me, I got a suit on, and I'm breeding a different type of symbiote, then they won't need protection like this. So he presses a button. And just as soon as he presses the button, the tower explodes and spews symbiote all over the town with the Avengers down below, so that doesn't sound good. Peter Parker's starting to wake up from his battle with Ben Grimm, and he's starting to go after Mr. Fantastic, who is still fighting Johnny Storm. And just then you hear a gunshot, and MJ is actually the one who shot Mr. Fantastic in the back. I don't know if he's dead or alive, or if he's going to tie into issue 5 or not in the finale. But Peter realizes, oh god, all the Avengers have turned into symbiote versions of themselves. So this went from bad to worse. And that's how it ends right there. It goes from bad to worse. It sets up a very nice action-packed issue 5 finale. I cannot wait to see how Peter Parker gets out of the situation, what he's going to have to sacrifice or give up to get out of the situation, and what it's going to take for his character to pull through. I cannot wait till issue 5 comes out, but let me know down below what you guys think of issues 1, 2, 3, or 4 of Spider-Man Spider-Shadow. Make sure you like, subscribe, or share, and as always, keep it right here on Dorkston. Make sure feel free to check out other episodes of Wet Ink, which are down below, or Tech Rec, or Dorkston Movie Minute, and keep it right here on Dorkston, guys. I've been your host, Ghost. Adios.